each airport in the National Airspace System has unique and distinct characteristics, which can sometimes lead pilots to use the wrong surface in taxi, takeoff, or landing operations. Let's take a look at some of these tricky areas from the flight deck. Montgomery-Gibbs Executive is a small, primarily business and general aviation-oriented airport, located just 6 miles northeast of San Diego International, 3 miles south of Miramar Marine Corps Air Station, and only 8 miles west of Gillespie Field. The complex Southern California airspace, including the San Diego Class Bravo and the Montgomery-Gibbs and Gillespie Field Class Delta, necessitates the requirement for some unique arrival routes. This is particularly true for Montgomery-Gibbs arrivals from the north and west. These aircraft can expect to be routed to and then south of Mount Soledad for entry into the airport's traffic pattern. This VFR reporting point is located 6 miles west of Montgomery-Gibbs. After navigating the congested airspace around Montgomery-Gibbs Executive, the pilot is met with a complex runway configuration consisting of two parallel runways, 10 and 28 left and right, and intersecting runway 523. The taxiway system provides access to all parking and services located on the south side of the airport.
Central 39 Quebec, the Cherokee on short final before the parallel, your number 1, runway 28 right, put on in.
Cleared land, 28 right, 39 Quebec.
As with most airports with parallel runways and staggered thresholds, pilots need to be diligent in not only reading back the runway assigned, but operating on the correct runway as well. Hotspots 1 and 2 concern aircraft landing on runway 28 right and exiting the runway. Too many aircraft are clearing the runway and crossing runway 10 right 28 left without proper clearance, in some cases even after being instructed to and acknowledging hold short of runway 28 left. Pilots need to pay close attention to clearance and airport signage as they clear the runway. Taxiway Mike has the unique issue concerning aircraft exiting runway 28 right and not completely clearing it. While it is vitally important to hold short of 28 left until properly cleared, it is equally important to taxi far enough to cross the 28 right hold short markings and allow following aircraft to utilize the runway. Pilots are reminded that while clearing runway 28 right on any taxiway, aircraft should stay on the tower frequency until instructed to contact ground. By switching frequencies before instructed, controller workload is increased, resulting in more coordination required, adding complexity to an already challenging operation. While not a hotspot, taxiway Foxtrot also presents a hazard to pilots because aircraft were clearing runway 28 right and crossing 10 right 28 left without a clearance. Improved taxiway signage has had a large positive impact on this. However, the point still needs to be reinforced. You cannot cross any runway without proper clearance from ATC. Aircraft rolling out on runway 28 right have sometimes turned onto intersecting runway 523 without a clearance. However, even if you receive a clearance to exit onto runway 523, you must have a clearance to cross runway 10 right 28 left. Hotspot 2 highlights this concern. Once again, a clearance is required to taxi onto any runway, active or not. A clearance onto one runway does not mean you are authorized to enter another.
Centurion 39 Quebec, cross runway 28 left.
Hotspot 3 concerns aircraft taxiing for takeoff on runway 28 right. Pilots cleared to taxi to runway 28 right via Hotel Alpha have confused taxiway Bravo with taxiway Alpha. They turn left on taxiway Bravo and across the approach end of runway 28 left without authorization. Even with the addition of surface-painted visual cues and taxiway signage, this remains an issue. Clearly understanding your taxi route clearance via electronic or paper means before you taxi will go a long way towards eliminating this mistake and others like it. When in doubt, or even feeling slightly confused, you can always ask the controller. Both of you will be much happier with a little extra time taken versus a possible incident or accident. Being aware of the hotspots and other configuration issues at Montgomery-Gibbs Executive Airport will help pilots make better decisions, and along with the air traffic control tower, keep the operation safe and efficient. Now you're better prepared for your trip to Montgomery-Gibbs Executive Airport. It's always better to know before you go.